morning, my dear students, and welcome to Big Data Analytics class. So in today's class, you are going to learn about Apache Pig operators. So the most important thing behind the pig is nothing but the operators. It is the backbone. Why the pig became more popular, even though you are not writing the Java programming, it is because of the built-in operations or operators present in the pig. So let us see what are the operators present in the pig. Apache Pig operators. So what are Apache Pig operators? Are high level procedural language. So these are nothing but they are high level procedural language for querying large data sets using Hadoop and MapReduce platform. So I repeat it once again, Apache Pig operators are high level procedural language for querying large data sets using MapReduce and Hadoop platform. And Pig Latin statement is an operator that makes a relation as an input and produces another relation as output. This is very, very important point. We need to focus on this. So the Pig Latin statement is an operator that takes relation as an input. That means relation is nothing but a table. So to perform any job, the pig will take the input as a relation or as a table, as well as after performing its operation, after performing its processing, the output will be also given in the form of relation only. So we need to keep a point that the input will be in the form of a relation and the output will be also in the form of relation. Right. The operators are the main tools for Pig Latin, which provides to operate on the data. They allow you to transform it by doing many things such as sorting, grouping, joining, projecting and filtering. That means by using the operators present in the pig, you can perform the sorting mechanism, you can perform the grouping mechanism, you can perform the joining mechanism and various other operations such as filtering, etc. So short and sweet, what is the Apache operators? They are nothing but they are a high level procedural language for querying large data sets using the Hadoop MapReduce, and whenever they perform any operations, they will be taking the input as a relation and the output will be also given as a relation. And what they will be performing? They will be performing the sorting, they will be performing the grouping, joining, projecting and filtering. So let us see here, the Pig Apache operators are classified as relational operators are one and diagnostic operators are one. So I repeat it once again, the Pig operators are classified as two types, relational operators and diagnostic operators. So let us first learn about relational operators, then we'll go with the diagnostic operators. So these are the relational operators present in the Pig. So we have categorized the Pig relational operators under five categories. That is nothing but loading and storing is one category, filtering is one category, grouping and joining is another category, sorting is another category, combining and splitting is another category. I am repeating once again, the Pig operators are classified as two types, that is called as the relational operators and diagnostic operators. So now we are seeing the relational operators. So relational operators are classified under five categories. What are the five categories? Loading and storing is one category, filtering is one category, grouping and joining is another category, sorting is another category, combining and splitting is another category. So these are the different categories. So under the loading and storing category, what are the operators will be there is, under the loading and storing category, operators will be load, store and dump. What is the purpose of load? Load is nothing but it loads the data from the file system or other storage location into a relation. Because in the previous slide itself, I have told you that the Pig operators takes the input as a relation and output will be given in the form of a relation. So that's what I'm telling here. It loads the data from the file system or other storage location. If you are getting into the Pig in the local mode, the data will be taken from the local file system. If you are entering into the Pig in the Hadoop mode or MapReduce mode, you'll be accessing the data from other location, that is from the HDFS. And once it gets the data, it will be in the form of a relation. So another operator is called as store. What is a store? It saves a relation to the file system or other storage. That means whatever the operations you perform in the PIG, they will not be stored unless and until you are going to use the operator store. Keep this point in the mind, because after completing the work, when you quit the PIG, what is going to happen? Whatever the job you have done, they will not be there. All will be deleted, and if you want, they should be saved. You have to make use of store operator. The other operator is called as a dump. What is a dump? It is nothing but it prints a relation to the console. That's nothing but whenever you want to print the output, you're going to use a dump command. For example, in SQL, whenever you want to print the output or see the query output, then you're going to use select command. Similarly, here also you're going to use the dump command. So the next category is called as a filtering. What is a filtering here? It basically works on the filters. So what are the operators present in the filtering is, filter is one operator, distinct is another operator, for each generate is another operator, stream is another operator. So how they work? Filter removes unwanted rows from a relation. Distinct removes duplicate rows from a relation. That means it gives the unique values. For each generate, adds or removes fields from relation. So whenever you want to add or whenever you want to remove the fields from a relation, you are going to use for each generate. What is a stream? The stream operator transforms a relation using a external programs. So these are the operators present in the filtering. Next we will go to the another category, that is called as grouping and joining. So what are the operators present in the grouping and joining? Join, co-group, group and cross. What is a join? Join operator basically performs, it joins two or more relations. It joins two or more relations. What is a co-group? Co-group is nothing but it groups the data into two or more relations. What is a group? It groups the data in a single relation. So please understand the difference between co-group and group. Very frequently asked questions in the interviews as well as in the examination. What is the difference between group and co-group? So group will be working on the single relation, and co-group will be working on the two or more relations. What about the cross? It creates the cross product of two or more relations. That is nothing but a Cartesian product, which you have learned in the SQL. The another category of is called as sorting, and in the sorting we have two operators, that is called as order and limit. What is the order? It sorts a relation by one or more fields, either in the ascending order or in the descending order. What is a limit here? Limit is nothing but limits the size of a relation to maximum number of tuples. If you don't use the limit command, if you have 100 tuples are there, tuples are nothing but rows. If you have 100 tuples are there, all those 100 tuples will be coming and you might not able to see the full output because your screen size is smaller. So I want to make it limit. I want to see the 10 tuples. I want to see the 3 tuples. Then I am going to use the limit operator. The last category is called as combining and splitting. So for combining and splitting category, we have two operators, that is called as union and split. What is a union? It combines two or more relations into one. I have two or more relations and I want to combine as a one. Then I am going to use the operator called as union. What is a split here? It splits the relation into two or more relations. For example, whatever the salaries more than 10,000 is there, I want that it should come in one relation, and salaries more less than 10,000 should come in another relation. So in to perform that job, I have to use the split operator, right? So these are the relational operators present in the PIG, which we have categorized in 5 categories, that is loading and storing, filtering, grouping and joining, sorting, combining and splitting. So the backbone of the PIG is nothing but these are the operators. So using these operators, we'll be performing all the PIG commands on the grunt, we'll be writing the PIG scripts and we'll be executing it. Let us see the diagnostic operators. So what are the diagnostic operators are there? We'll see here. So we have only three diagnostic operators. So what are the three diagnostic operators? As the word diagnostic, it is for diagnosis purpose basically. We don't use much diagnostic operators because these diagnostic operators will be used by the administrators, Hadoop administrators. So whenever they want to perform any diagnosis of the commands of the PIG scripts, then we are going to use the diagnostic operator. So we have three diagnostic operators, that is describe, explain and illustrate. What is a describe? It prints the relation schema. That means whatever the schemas are there, I may forget the schema of my relation. So at that time I want the schema, then I am going to use the describe. Explain, it's nothing but it explains about the logical plan and physical plans. So it is going to explain how the PIG scripts will be executed, its logical plan and physical plan. What is the illustrate? It shows the execution of logical plan and using the generate subset of the input. That means these three diagnostic operators will be useful by the administrators to know how the PIG scripts or PIG commands can be executed by its logical plan or a physical plan, and how it is executing systematically, how much memory is going to be, how much memory is occupied or used, and how many nodes are being utilized. All those things can be diagnosed by the diagnostic operators. So that is about the diagnostic operators and the relational operators. So now we are going to see about in detail about the relational operators. So how the relational operators will be working, we are going to see one by one. So relational operators are the main tools using which PIG-LATEN operates on the data. So relational operators are the main tools using which PIG-LATEN operates on the data. And it allows you to transform the data by storing, grouping, joining, projecting and filtering. So let us see now the relational operators one by one. So let us start with load. What is a load is? The load operator is used to load data from the file system or from the HDFS storage into the PIG relation. So this is the fundamental job we have to do. That is nothing but whenever we are working with PIG, whatever the data or wherever the data present in the location, maybe the file system or maybe the HDFS storage, whatever it could be, first we need to load in the form of a PIG relation, right? So that is the thing. And so let us see an example. So in this example, the load operator loads the data from the first to form a relation loading one. So this is my file. This file consists of some data. To work with that file, I have to load. So to load, what I am doing now, I am loading in the relation called as loading one. So I am making a new relation called as a loading one. I repeat it once again, this is a temporary relation and it will not be stored. If you want to store, you have to make use of store operator. That means when you are coming out of the mode, maybe a local mode or a Hadoop mode, they will not be stored. If they want to be stored, you have to make use of store operator. So what is the example we are doing? In this example, the load operator loads data from the file called as first. And it is forming a relation. What is the new relation name? Loading one. So this is my data set. This is my data set. And this data set, data I am loading using the operator called as a load. And I am making a relation. And what is the relation name? Loading one. It is a temporary relation name. So this file has three fields. That is user, URL and ID. This first data set has fields that is called as a user, URL and ID. Actually, there will not be any fields. I have framed it according to my requirement because I am making a relation. That means in the loading one, these are the fields will be there. But in first data set, there will not be any fields. Once I am making as a relation, I am giving the field names as user, URL and ID. That means we have three columns data set present in the first. So to do the job, how to do that is, I am making use of grunt shell commands. So what is the command I am giving here? So load is my operator. I am accessing by using the root here, my file, my first file is there in the root. So that is my location of the file. Using pig storage, comma, that is nothing but this first file is having a comma separated values. So comma as, that means my first file is having data like this. Shyam, comma, URL may be Amazon, and ID, I am giving some ID as 18. So these are the fields are there, and I am making use of comma separated fields. So what I am saying, using pig storage comma as, what is the field name I am making? User. What is the data type? Char array is one data type because characters are there. URL is a one field, and what is the data type? Char array, and characters I'm keeping, and last column I'm making the field name as ID, and its data type is integer. So I'm making a new relation. The name of the new relation is loading one. So this loading one is having three fields, that is called as user, URL, ID. So user field data type is char array, URL data type is char array, ID is integer. Similarly, you can make another relation also. So another relation name is a loading 2. I am repeating again, loading 1 is a temporary relation, loading 2 is also temporary relation. But this data sets are present in the file system. So load root second, that's nothing but my file location. My file is available in the root. Using pig storage, again I am making use of comma separated value. I am making three fields, URL and rating. So URL data type is char array and rating data type is integer. So I have made a two relations, that is called as a loading one and loading two. So in loading one, I have three columns, I have three fields. One is user, another is URL, another is ID. This is loading one. And I made another relation that is called as a loading two. It has two fields, that is URL and rating. URL and rating. So by using the load command, what is going to happen is whatever the data present in this data set will come into this with these fields, because when you are making the relation, you have to make the fields also. But in data set there will not be any fields, just normal data will be there. We need to organize according to our requirement. And using the data set second, I have loaded, using the load operator, I have created another relation with two fields, that is called as a URL and rating. So what I want to tell you is, if you want to perform any work, if you want to perform any job, first of all you have to load the data present in the file system or in the HDFS in the form of a relation. Because did you remember or not, in our previous sessions, as I told you, that the operators will take the input as a relation and the output also as a relation. That means output also will be given in the form of a relation. So that is about the load operator. So I have made loading one relation and loading two relation. So loading one is having the data set of first with three fields, user, URL and ID. And I have made one more relation, that is called the loading two, with the data set called as a second. What is the location present of this? The location is root. And loading two has two fields, that is URL and rating. Let us see about another operator that is called as for each. So how the for each will be working is, this operator basically generates data transformation based on the columns of the data. I repeat it once again. This operator generates data transformation based on the columns of the data, and it is used to add or remove fields from a relation. And we are going to use for each generate operation to work with the columns of the data. So whenever I want to work with the columns of the data, I am going to make use of for each generate. So let us see the example here. As in our previous slide, I have shown you, we have made two relations, loading 1 and loading 2. So for each, loading 1, that is the first relation, generate URL comma ID. So I have 3 fields are there, but I don't want third one. I want 2 only, that is user ID and ID. I don't want user, URL and ID. So since I want data, because as I said you that it is going to operate on the data present in the columns. So all those will be coming, and I have made a one more relation. So we should not forget one important thing. Operators will take the input as a relation. Operator will give the output as a relation. So what is the input here? This is my input. Is it in the relation form? Yes, we made a relation already in our previous slide. What is the output? The output is nothing but we made another relation. What is another relation name? For underscore each. What is there in this now? To see that, I am using the dump here. So dump is nothing but it is just like a print command. I want to print whatever it is there. So for underscore each. So what is the result I got? I got all these. That means these are the data present in the for each. That means the for each operator is used to extract all the data. So I have extracted data from URL column and ID column from this relation, and I made a new relation that is called for underscore each, and this relation has got all the data. So I am printing it by using the operator called as dump. So we have another operator that is called as a filter. What is a filter? This operator selects tuples from a relation based on a condition. So in this example, what we are going to do is, we are going to filter the record from loading 1. What we are going to do? We are going to filter the records from loading 1 with the condition ID greater than 8. That means if the ID is greater than 8, I want to filter the data now. So what I am writing the command here? Filter is my operator. As you know that the operator takes the input as a relation. So this is my relation which I have already made. By ID greater than 8, this is my condition. This is my operator. This is my relation name which I have already made previously, and this is my condition. So whatever the output is there, I am making the output in the form of a new relation. The new relation name is called as a filter underscore dump. So I am repeating again and again, the operator takes input as a relation and output as a relation. So I made a new relation called as a filter underscore command. So to see the output, dump filter underscore command, so we got all this output. That means what I asked, I want all the IDs greater than 8. So less than 8 I didn't got. I got 8, I got 10, I got 12. So that is about the filter. Let us see about the another operator that is called the join. What is the join operator? The join operator is used to perform an inner equi-join of two or more relations based on common field values. The join operator always performs inner join. Inner join basically ignores the null values, so it makes sense to filter them out before the using the join. That means it basically ignores the inner null values. So before performing the inner join, make sure that there should not be any null values, or you remove the null values. So in this example, what we are going to do is, we are going to join two relations based on column URL from loading 1 and loading 2. So as per your remembrance, in loading 1 also we have a field called as a URL, and in loading 2 also we have a field called as URL, right? So I am joining here. So join is my operator. The join operator is taking the input as a relation, and what is the relation name? Loading 1 by URL. That means this URL field is present in this relation, and this field is present in this relation. I am joining it by the URLs of loading 1 and loading 2. Whatever the output is coming, the output I am making as a new relation, and the new relation name is join underscore command. Join underscore command. So in this relation, I got the output. I got the output. So to see the output, I am making use of dump join underscore command, because the dump operator works like a print. So what is the output I got here? Wherever my URLs are same here, my URLs are CNN. So here same, cramp, flicker, my blog. So we got the answer here, that is we are joined by the URLs of loading 1 and URL of loading 2. So let us see about the order by. What is going to happen in the order by here? Order by is used to sort the relation based on one or more fields. And we are going to order the relations on the basis of columns, either ascending or descending, by using the ASC and DESC keywords. So what is the example is, order is my operator name, and as you know that the operator takes the input as relation. So what is my relation name here? Loading 2 is my relation name, and by rating ASC, I want to sort the field called as rating in the form of a ascending order. So whatever the output will be coming, we need to store the output in the form of a new relation. So what is the new relation I am making here? Loading 4 is a new relation, and the loading 4 new relation will be having all the output of ratings in the ascending order. To see the output, I am using the dump operator, as the dump operator is nothing but like a print command. So dump loading 4, because the output is in the loading 4. So these are the output we got, because I asked in ascending order, so I got in ascending order 2, 7, 9, 9. This is the output we got. So that is about the order by. Next we will see about the distinct. What is the distinct here? The distinct will be removing the duplicate values. That means duplicate tuples will be removed by the distinct here. So let us take an input file which has these values, AMR cramp 8 and AMR cramp my blog. So here in this file, I have 2 times repeated user IDs are there. So when we apply the distinct on the data, so duplicate entries will be removed. So this is my file, my first file. So it has this data. So these are all my duplicates here. So Amar, my duplicate values are there. So I want it should be removed here. So what is the thing I am applying here? Loading, I am saying here load is my operator first of all. Load, I am loading the file, my input data set, that is this is my input data set, which is present in the root, using pig storage as I want 3 fields, user, URL, ID. So these are my 3 fields are there, user, URL and ID, and they are comma separated values. So that is why I have given as comma, pig storage comma. So whatever the output given by this command will be making a one more new relation, that is called as a loading one. That means I am making a fresh loading one. Already we made it, but I have repeating it once again. So it will be rewritten. So I am using here distinct operator loading 1. So distinct operator is taking the input file as a relation, and the relation name is nothing but a loading one. So whatever the duplicate values present in the loading one will be removed by the distinct operator, and the output will be given, and the output will be stored in the form of a new relation that is called as a loading three. So to see the output, if I say dump loading three, dump is my operator, and loading three, it is going to give the data. So what is that here? See here, I got CNN for one time only, cramp for one time, flip for one time, likewise. But here I have so many times, AMR is there, user ID, but it has been shown for one time only. So in this fashion, the distinct operator will remove the duplicate values. So let us see about the store. What is the basic purpose of store here? As I was telling you every time, that the operator will take the input as a relation and output will be in the form of a relation. But whatever the relations we are making temporarily, they will not be stored. If you feel that they should be stored, then you have to use the operator called as store. What is the store here? Store is used to save the results to the file system. That means I feel that whatever the output I am showing using the dump command, it should be so stored somewhere so that tomorrow I may use it. Then use the store. So how you are going to do is, look at here. You can see here, I am saying store loading 3. So in the previous slide, we made a loading 3 which has got all the distinct values. So store loading 3 into root folder, in the root folder with the file name called as a storing. So all the data present in the loading 3 will be stored in this file location, and whenever you want, you can reflect it. So you can see here, you can go to the file system and you can say here storing, here all the data has been stored here. All the data has been stored here. If you don't use the store command, certainly the data will not be, certainly these relations, whatever the temporary relations I have made, loading 1, loading 2, loading 3, loading 4, all those relations will not be stored unless and until you use the store operator. So you can use the store operator like this. Your next operator is called as a group. What is a group here? The group operator groups together the tuples with the same group key in the form of a key field values. The key field will be tuple if the group key has more than one field, otherwise it will be same type as that of group key. The result of a group operation is a relation that includes one tuple per group. So in this example, group the relation loading by column URL. So I am grouping the relation called as loading one using the column called as URL. So let us do how to do the grouping here. So group is my operator, and this operator making use of relation called as a loading one by the column called as URL. So it makes use of group, and the output will be stored in a new relation called as group underscore command. And to see the output, I am saying dump group underscore command. So all are grouped here. Look at here, CNN, all are grouped in one place, cramp in one place, flickr in one place, my blog in one place, because I have done the grouping based on the URL. So what is my URL? CNN is one URL, cramp is my URL, flickr is one URL, my blog is another URL. So I have done the grouping based on the URL. So that is about the grouping operator. We have another operator that is called as a co-group. So group will work on the single relation, and co-group will work on the multiple relations. So let us see the example here. So I am making use of two relations, loading one and loading two, and I am making use of URL field, which is common in both the relations. That means in loading one and loading two, I have this relation that is called as a URL. So let us see here. So co-group is my operator. This operator is taking the input as a relation one, loading one by URL, and loading two by URL. That means this operator is making use of input relation that is called as a loading one, and my column is URL, and loading two, another relation by URL. Group has taken one relation, But co-group can make use of two or more than any number of relation. So whatever the output given by the co-group operator, that will be stored in a new relation, and the new relation name is called as co-group underscore command. And what is the output we got, I can show you by using the dump, because dump is just like a print command. So I am saying dump and new relation name, that is called as co-group underscore command. So what is the output we got here? CNN, cramp, flickr, myblog. So as per the URLs of both the relations, loading one and loading two, I have got the answer. So I have done the grouping. So that is about the co-group. Next we will see about the cross. So cross is nothing but it is going to work as a Cartesian product of two or more relations. So let us see here, we are applying cross product on loading 1 and loading 2. We are applying cross product on loading 1 and loading 2. So cross is my operator, and this operator is taking two relations, that is called as loading 1 and loading 2. So it is going to do the Cartesian product, and the output of the Cartesian product will be stored in the form of a new relation, that is called as a cross underscore command. So if I want to see the output, I am going to say dump cross command, cross underscore command. So this is the output of the cross operator or Cartesian product. Let us see about the one more operator, that is called as a limit. What is a limit? The limit operator is used to limit the number of output tuples. If the specified, let us see here, example, I am saying here limit is my operator, loading 1 is my relation 3. That means I want only 3 tuples. So these 3 tuples will be stored in a new relation called as limit underscore command. So to see the output, dump limit underscore command. So I got only 3 rows, 1, 2 and 3, because you have given the limit as 3. So whenever you want to see a particular number of tuples, then prefer to use limit. Yeah, we have a split. So what is a split operator? It is used to split the partitions, the content of relations into two or more relations based on some expressions. So whatever the content present in a relation, I want to split them based on some expressions. So what are the expressions here? Depending upon the conditions will be the expressions. So split the loading 2 into two relations, that is called as X and Y. I want to split the relation, that is called as a loading 2, into two relation, that is called as a X is one relation and Y is another relation. So what I want here, X relation created by loading 2 contains the fields rating is greater than 8. That means whatever the rating is greater than 8 should come to the X relation, and whatever the rating is less than 8 should come to the Y relation. So in the loading 2 relation, I have all rating mixed, from 1 to 100 all ratings are mixed. But what is my necessity here? I want to make sure that all the ratings more than 8 should come to the X relation and less than 8 should come to the Y relation. So to do that job, we are going to make use of the operator called as split. So let us see the command here, how it works. Split is my operator. Loading 2 is my input file into X. X is one new relation. Rating greater than 8. So all the tuples whose rating is more than 8 will be in the X, and all the tuples whose rating is less than 8 or equal to 8 will come to the Y. So two relations will be made, that is called as X and Y. So all the X will be having tuples more than 8 rating, and all the tuples more than less than equals 8 will be there in the Y relation. So that is all about our relational operators we have seen. And now we are going to see about the diagnostic operators, and the diagnostic operators are only 3. So what are these? Is already every time I am making use of dump. So dump operators is used to run pig Latin statements and display the results on the screen. So all the round I have made use of dump, and dump operator is used to print. So dump loading one, as I shown you that to print the output, I'm going to use the dump operator, and dump operator is a part of diagnostic operators. The another operator is called as a describe operator. What is a describe operator? The describe operator is nothing but to know about the schema of the relation, because it is not possible to remember the schemas of the relation. I may forget the schemas of the relation. To know the schemas of the relation, I am going to use the operator that is called as describe and the relation name. So when you use relation name, then I got the schema. User is one field, URL is another field, ID is another field. User data type is char array, URL data type is char array, ID data type is integer. So that is about the describe operator of diagnostic. The another operator is called the illustrate. What is a illustrate here? Illustrate is nothing but this operator is used to review how data is transformed through sequence of pig Latin statements. So illustrate command is best when it comes for debugging script. Whenever you are going for a debugging script, at that time you can be using the illustrate. So illustrate loading one, it will be showing all what are the fields are there, what are the data types are there, all these things you are going to make use of it. So the illustrate command is best when it comes for the debugging process. That means for debugging purpose you can make use of the illustrate. We have a explain here. What is the explain operator will do? It prints the logical and the physical plans. So how internally it will be executed, and if the administrator want to check that the physical plan and the logical plan, that can be seen by using the explain operator. And how to use the explain operator? Explain and the relation name. So internally it is going to show how it is going to work. So it will be very, very useful for the administration purpose. So thank you so much for listening the class. So in today's class we have learned in detail about the pig operators, which are classified as two types, that is called as a relational operators and diagnostic operators. The entire working of the pig is based on the operators only, and short and sweet, operators always takes the input as a relation and gives the output as a relation. That is the reason I have made number of relations and the outputs also as a number of relations. Thank you so much for listening the class. We'll meet in the next session. Thank you.